Thank you very much. Finally, we're back again. It's something I really look forward to is waking up on this very special Saturday morning and being able to drive to Stærbæk and just have one of the biggest experiences of the year. I think this place is, good morning, growing more and more. Many familiar faces, also some new ones, and people traveling from very, very far corners of the world. I think maybe the prize for the most endurance goes to the people who drove from Croatia, bringing a little trailer, driving at slow speeds all the way up to Denmark. It's extremely impressive. I think what's very special about this place also is that it's a true LEGO fan event. It's yes, we do have a store over here and so on, but I think this is really for the fans. And that's what makes it so fascinating to be here. And I can say, as a LEGO person, being part of running the company, it gives a lot of energy to meet people like you and see what happens here, because it's so fascinating what you are able to do with the LEGO bricks and out of just a few simple pieces to make the most amazing things. It gives us a lot of energy to experience this. I think I've been asked to, as always, when I can, say a few things about how the LEGO Group is doing, what's happening right now, so I'll do that. Some of you will have heard me say these things many times before, also last year, I think. But I'm happy to say that the LEGO as a company and brand and toys continue to do extremely well, despite the Euro crisis and earthquakes and financial crisis and what else is happening in the world around us. More and more children are playing with LEGO. One of the reasons is that we're quite successful with introducing the LEGO experience in places in the world where it's still something quite new. For instance, we're growing more than 50% in China and are now the number one toy brand in that big country, so we're very interested in continuing to make sure that LEGO becomes more and more known in Asia. Over the past month, we have changed the organization in the LEGO Group, and one of the purposes of that is to make sure that Asia, particularly China and Southeast Asia, the very eastern part of Asia, becomes a new home market for the LEGO Group, just like Europe and the Americas is a home market for the LEGO Group. We are also growing a lot in places like Mexico and Spain. Spain, of course we're growing, that's a long story. But Brazil, so we really want to bring LEGO to these new places. I think that's going to take 10 years for that to evolve, but it's a very positive development for us. And we're so pleased also that in those countries it's also with the LEGO education concept, so we are entering schools in many countries like India, South Africa, China, Brazil, and we find that quite important because, as you know, I think I've told many of you many times that the best, some would say, I would actually argue, the only way to learn is to play, because when we just listen, like you're listening now, you're thinking about something else, there's a little voice in your head, and if you don't think you have a little voice in the head, it's the little voice in your head that's saying, what time was dinner tonight? I'm not sure I make it for dinner. What is this guy you're talking to? By the way, who is he? I'm the CEO of the company. But the only way to learn is to play. When you play with LEGO, you learn really a logical, systematic language. You learn to think science and math, but you also learn that you can build anything and you can be very creative. And I think that's what we want to give to all these children in the schools in these countries, that they can be creative problem solvers, that they can create their own things. And the beautiful thing is that many of them have access to the internet. So when you put something out there with what you have created, there's actually a wider and wider audience that's seeing this and getting impressed with it and getting inspired with it and saying, I can do that. Today I feel very lucky because I've been able to bring at least half of my family, so my two sons, my daughters are at a birthday party. Unfortunately, they prefer that to a LEGO event. But my boys definitely are here, and they brought a friend, and he's a real big LEGO fan. His name is Jesper, he's over there. And sometimes when Jesper comes to our household to visit. He lives quite far away, and then he stays with us for a couple of days. Then one day my oldest son Sebastian said, "It's good Jesper is here because I had lost my imagination. But now Jesper is here, now I've got it back." So I think children really understand the concept of what Lego gives them and what it does to them. So thank you for also being part of showing that in so many ways. I wanted to mention two other things that are happening in Lego, and then I'll stop telling you a lot about Lego. There's an important industrial revolution going on in society, and you know this, of course. It's called the Internet. It's been around for 10, 15 years. We think that we've seen all of it with Facebook and Google. A lot of people think that's only the beginning. In the future, we will not know the difference between a video game and an online game or mobile phone game. It's all converging and we'll be in touch in ways we have never imagined. And maybe we'll have little chips inside Lego bricks that will tell us exactly where they are and we can look it up on the phone. I don't know, but at least this morning in my mailbox, I got the secret code for a very exciting Lego app that will be available in the App Store within a month, and in Apple's retail stores worldwide, which will allow you to play with Lego bricks and using your iPhone in some interesting ways. The product is called Life with George, and I'm looking forward to testing this afternoon. But I think it should be a fun but small beginning of what may be possible in the future between the virtual world, the digital world, and of course also the physical world. Because I want to be sure that you know that Lego is not leaving the physical world behind. Sometimes when we talk about the future of the Lego group, I call it the vision of Lego 2.2. So what is Lego 1.0? It's the wooden toy company that started 80 years ago as a family-owned business and remains a family-owned business that has never bought other businesses, just grown by staying true and focusing on its idea. Then I call it 2.0, that's when we became fully based on the plastics, i.e. the Lego brick and the building system. And then I like to call it 2.1, when Kelly was also here today, introduced the minifigure, the play themes, Lego Space. Many of us remember from our childhood how that created all the changes with cars and space and so on. And now I call it 2.2 to signify that it is Lego with digital content. But you have to be very careful and see that I don't call it 3.0, because 3.0 would mean forget about plastics, like we forgot about wood. We will never leave the physical world behind us. And there's a couple of important reasons for that. One is actually the brain does not develop if we don't move. That's why my four-year-old daughter this morning in the kitchen said, "Where are you going today?" I said, "I'm going to a Lego family." "Well, why are you going to a Lego family?" "Because I'm going to a family." And I said, "Stop jumping." She said, "No, you're jumping." Because when you're 4 years old, you need to jump, otherwise you're not growing your brain. You need to use your hands, you need to move around. That's why animals play, that's why human beings play, and people like yourself never stop playing, which means you have better brains that continue to grow. And so I think the physical play should never go away, and we are very convinced about that. We also think it would be impossible to have the same experience without the physical play, so building digitally is just not the same. The example I always use is it's like reading a great book and then watching it on TV as a movie or in the movie theater. Two different experiences, they're both great, but I at least know I often prefer reading the book for 30 hours, forgetting myself, disappearing for half a day, if the kids allow it, and just loving to read a great book, and it's fine to watch the movie, but that lasts an hour or 30 minutes, it's not the same thing. I think you also know that it's very hard actually to be the person who authored, who wrote the book, and to be the person who directs the movie, because it's two very different art forms. And this is where Lego also needs to understand that the people who are great with physical bricks are not necessarily great at creating a video game. So we are building separate competencies, if you like. We need to work with partners, but we will continue to try and be both physical and virtual. The virtual world has many elements. It's what happens on apps, for instance. It's what happens on mobile and social gaming. It's what's happening with Lego video games, and Lego video games is developed with a partner who's very, very good, and so these games are quite successful, as some of you may be aware. Next to Nintendo, it's apparently the best-selling video game for children worldwide. And when the new Nintendo Wii, it's called Wii U platform, launches later next year, nobody knows exactly when because it's not really working. The first video game to be sold on the Nintendo Wii U platform, which is like an iPad and a Nintendo Wii in one thing, the first game to launch for that will be the Lego City video game, which we are really anticipating. Also quite worried about, because what is it? I've seen, of course, some early versions. It looks quite interesting, but I'm curious to see whether it will catch on. Obviously, very exciting development. And then, of course, we have Lego Universe, which is now in a new iteration. There's a Ninjago zone, there's a free-to-play zone, so that means you can play the first couple of stages. I think Lego Universe still has a lot to improve, but it's a gradual process. What's very important for us to a difference between Universe and the video games is that Lego Universe can be a real social game, that it has those characteristics of online social gaming, and that there's an ability to build and share building and even program in the same way that we're familiar with programming from products like Mindstorms or Wii. So that's maybe the most important things I wanted to share about what it means to be digital and be present and how we think about our future in that space. For anybody who has children, actually for any person in the world, you know how much time you spend on the internet, how much you use digital stuff in your everyday life. Yeah. I think it's just impossible to imagine a future where we're not somehow present in that area. Then the final piece I just wanted to highlight is that while the world is busy discussing economic crisis, we also have an energy crisis and climate challenges. And this is something that Lego is also taking very serious. We are very far along the path of making sure that all our energy comes from renewable sources of energy. So we make sure that we at least contribute to a better planet. And also we are constantly looking at the chemicals and substances and what are the materials that Lego bricks are made from. It's actually quite challenging because the materials we use are crucial to make the clutch power, and we cannot compromise the clutch power because then there's no value in the Lego brick. But we are certainly looking at various alternatives to see whether it can reduce energy consumption by using another material, whether it makes sure that the recycling is more safe, and so on. So these are the most important challenges for us, is dealing with becoming even more international, growing in these new countries, dealing with digitalization and dealing with the planet and energy issues. Then I just want to also stress that we are becoming a big company, as you know, it's very popular right now. But my aim is to make sure that whether Lego is very popular or just a little bit popular, we can survive all the time. So should we have a bad year, it should not be the end of us. So far we have had many good years, but we can also anticipate bad years someday. We've seen those before. And it's very important for us to do that. And I hope that one of the ways we can avoid that, or at least be also humble and ready for a bad year, is to have a very, very good dialogue. So I want to thank you for everything that you do to protect the brand and the company by being critical of what we do, the people inside the company. I know that to many people I'm just the guy who's taking care of your business. So I really appreciate that friendship and relationship, and I really hope that you will continue to send me emails or letters, your magazines in various languages, and continue to give me the feedback. I actually remember all the feedback I got last year when I was here, including where it's cool, we talked about the trains, the slowdown in the corners, and so on. It is important. Sometimes, of course, because you are the ultimate builders of Lego, you have very, very high demands. It's almost like if you want to build the best car in the world, you talk to the racing drivers and you ask them to drive the car, and you get very strong input, which is not necessarily how I as a personal driver feel, because I just really don't care so much about cars. I just want to get to a legal friendly event from my house. But we learn a lot from listening to the people who understand the product and the experience the very best. So I really hope that you will never feel like you cannot talk to us, like we will not listen to you, because that would be a terrible day for us. So I hope you continue to give us a lot of input and feedback and dialogue. Thank you for listening for such a long time.
Okay. Thanks. Come on, give me a really big anybody who has any questions? Or I think you have until we walk around. And
I'll be around for sure. Yes, so we can also we can also continue the dialogue at the various places. Yeah. All right. Have a great 2 days here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, what practical information? When you guys go